Hello friends, a very warm welcome to all of you on our daily fact series of Team Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on this channel we have multiple series which cover the syllabus of your UPSC CSC, and for this purpose we have started multiple series that cover your different components of GS general studies part. So this is a basically this series is a simple series. It is not related to any topic. It is just a kind of general series in which what we do, we daily provide you the simple facts. So in today's video we will be talking about the women in prisons. So friends, before talking about this issue, let me tell you that friends, we have also have a dedicated test series on our channel, the schedule of which is given before you on your screen. So this test series is for the purpose of UPSC CSC 2019. So this is the total 27 full length test series. So this is the this is the first slide in which the schedule of 14 tests is given, and this is the next slide in which the schedule of 15 to 27 tests is given. So if you are willing, you can join us, you can contact us at this email ID. So let's start our discussion friends. Our today's topic is women in prisons. So friends, I will start by simply by providing you some data. So this is the data which is recorded in 2015. So as of 2015, women constituted 4.3% of the inmates. So friends, if for example, if there are suppose 100 persons in prisons, then out of these 100, four were women as of 2015. So another data that is on your screen is that out of these 67%, approximately 67% are under trials. That means these are the women who have not been convicted in any case, but rather their cases are pending in different courts. And also the other data is that majority of the female inmates are in the age group of 18 to 50 years of age. So and last data is that out of 1401 prisons in India, only 18 are exclusive for women. It means that other prisons are such that in those prisons both men and women are kept. So only 18 prisons are there which are women specific. So this data was important to kind of quote here because I will explain the challenges faced, and you can better grasp the challenges by correlating with this data. So friends, the first challenges of the greater hardships that the women face in prisons. So as I have told you that women constitute only 4.3% of the inmates. That means they constitute a very small number, but due to their less visibility, there is a tendency while the making policy about the prisons that the women needs are ignored because they are less in number. So certainly there is very much possibility that women specific needs are ignored. So that's why they face greater hardships as compared to their male counterparts in the jails. And the second thing is of social stigma. So you know friends, Indian society is quite conservative, and if woman is lodged in jail, so certainly the social stigma that is associated with a woman being imprisoned is more as compared to the men being imprisoned. So another thing that is of financial dependence of the female on husband or the for that matter family. So in case of males, mostly they are self dependent. If they are imprisoned, the family members often visit them, but this is not case with females because mostly generally they are dependent upon their family and the husband. They are also financially dependent upon them. So certainly after the imprisonment, the family abandons the woman. So that's why they find it difficult to prove their case in the courts, and also there is much possibility in that case that woman may be convicted because they don't have that much of support which the male counterparts or the male inmates enjoy from their families. So that's why they are financially dependent, and this also enhances conviction rate. And another thing is of inadequacy of female staff. So in our prisons, friends, the female staff number is not that much, so that's why mostly the men are there in the prisons. And other thing is of lack of female specific needs. So simply it is clear that when only 4.3% of the inmates are women, so certainly there is a tendency to ignore the female specific needs. So there are physical, biological needs of the female which must be met in the prisons, but due to the approach that must be there, keeping in mind the women in prisons, that is not there. So another thing is of women with children. So friends, as I have told you that 18 to 50 years are the years which constitute the maximum proportion of the female inmates. That means 81% of the females who are imprisoned are between the age of 18 and 50. So certainly they will be childbearing. Obviously, if the child is minor, certainly it is most likely that he will accompany her mother in jails. In jail. Another thing is, if he is not accompanying, then it is very much possible that he must be there with the family. So women, motherly care is not available to children. So this is the another issue. So other issues of breaking of family ties. So as I have told you, so there is a social stigma that is associated with female in prison, and that's why it is more often that female prisoners experience breaking of family ties, because families do not visit them or they abandon them. And also this adds to their difficulty in reintegration into society, because when they are released, then in most cases it is observed that they are abandoned, they are not reintegrated into family, and they have to their social ties that they enjoyed with the family are broken. So that is the case. Another issue is of friend sexual harassment, because certainly if they are financially dependent upon the family, they are financially dependent upon the husband, and if they are abandoned by the family, then they will be vulnerable in jails. And also as there is inadequacy of female staff, so it is found that that female are sexually harassed or abused in jail. So this is another major issue. So this was the purpose of this video, to sensitize you people about the issues that women face in prison. So sir, some of you students, some of you people may say that obviously prisons are prisons for certain reason. They are not five-star hotels that the needs are to be met. But let me tell you friends that the person who is in prison is already serving he is in prison for the offense he has committed. So that's why he is the court has already snatched his freedom, right to freedom. So but the basic human rights are inalienable. The right to safe drinking water, right to safe environment, right to healthy food is the right of every human being. So you can't say ki if the person is lodged in jail, then you will deny that person the right to dignity, the right to food, the right to clean environment, the right to clean drinking water, the right to basic human services, right to health. So in this context, I will conclude by citing the quote of a famous person who was the leader of South Africa, that is Nelson Mandela. So he served quite long time in jails. So while he was an anti-apartheid activist, so he once said ki no one truly knows a nation until one has been inside its jails. A nation should not be just by how it treats its highest citizens, but its lowest ones. So friends, it is not the case that you people revere the highest citizens of the country. You will be judged by your actions, by your deeds towards the lowest citizens of your society. So this was the statement of Nelson Mandela, and this is all about my today's video. If you like the video, then please do hit a like, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel, and do not forget to press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the important notifications about the updates that we do on our channel. So thank you friends, have a very nice day. If you want to join our test series, you can contact us at this number or at this email ID. So thank you, have a very nice day.